Actually, one of my students' father, he was traveling, and the beggar knocked on his screen of the car.
Educated beggar, yeah.
Oh, maybe. Obviously, he had carried. He had carried the credit card machine. He said, "Give me a cup of tea." So he was offering, "I don't have change." So he said, "Give me your card," and he said, "Don't worry, I'll swipe only 10." He swiped 10 and he gave back the card to
him. Wow.
You must have developed that kind of system for a
All these myths are building up because of people like you.
And it was in Bangalore. This incident took place in Bangalore.
Wow. Crazy.
She's giving you an idea. If beggars were choosers. No. Beggars.com.
Beggars.com.
Yeah, please. Yeah.
I don't want to
you
pay.
You say you're talking to an investor about your company. What is this company? You started a new one?
No, Shopshop, which I explained. Yeah. I'm now a full-time CEO of that company, and we're building it all over scratch. So it's two founders. It's myself and another CEO of another large company, or a mid-sized company, which was in learning called TeamMind. So we both resigned from as CEOs one fine day, and we thought we'll build this new startup. So
I have a question for you. I'm about to embark on my PhD now, and I'll be doing a research on the e-commerce models that are there, especially on e-tailing, Amazon, Flipkart, etc. So since they're all in red right now, do you see them getting into the green soon? Do you think that they will be making money finally for themselves in India?
So what I strongly believe is there's they're all burning cash. It's no-brainer, right? So the only thing is how long they sustain. I didn't want to name one of them, but I know that they're... See, how it works in e-commerce industry is that from day one they start and until where they are, every day they have to show growth. Every day they have to show growth. Every funding cycle that they do has to be at higher valuation. There is no way you can raise a next round of funding at the same valuation that you raised the previous round, which means that it's for sure it's a bad scene. And we know the successive round would go like this. And I know that the promoters also want to sell off their own equity so that they can fuel the operations. You don't sell family silver to fuel your company's operations. So I think that they were all inspired by the American models. And in US, of course, why people are willing to pay the premium for shipping charges is because of the convenience. In India, people buy on e-commerce because of the deep discounts models. Deep discounts was good to build a wave, but they can't sustain with those deep discounts models. So what I think is there will be consolidation of the model. I mean, there will be consolidation of some of them. And we hope and we wish that the bubble has to burst to an extent so that there is calibration in the market. There are calibrations on the valuations that which they have raised at. So it's also very important that founders don't raise at a very higher valuation at the initial days because a successive round of funding will become an issue.
Any other questions?
I thought you were changing your PhD topic and writing on him. On his model.
Yeah, why is he a role model?
Yes.
Good afternoon to all of you. My name is Tanu. I'm a little curious because you've been mentioning that you left your previous job as the CEO of the company that you built. I'm just curious that why did you do it if it's not a very personal question to ask?
That's exactly what I told. When your absence is no more felt in your own company, it's like a big board that you're seeing everywhere saying that we don't need you anymore. So. And also the other thing is when the organization has scaled to an extent and the process is well engineered and it's more of kind of a process oriented company and it's less of the people. And what I felt personally is over the last 2 years, when we started we went like this, it was like a hockey stick curve. And after that we were not so aggressive as we did. So that's exactly where I felt that probably that's exactly what I was mentioning, that organizations has to sustain, has to innovate and has to pivot when they are successful. Most of them would pivot when they have failed, but I strongly believe is that at least when you are successful, when you have resources, when you have enough cash, when you have your employees, your core team with you, that's the best time when you see that, okay, we've enjoyed with this journey. Is there any way that we could pivot to do something? And the company wanted to pivot into big data and analytics. They wanted to focus on software solutions for the education industry, public sector, which is opportunity that's right. And I wasn't passionate on those industries, of course, as much as my other management team were. And that's exactly where I felt that, okay, is there any way that we could appoint someone else as the CEO of the company who is passionate, who is able to scale the company to another level? And for me, I do not feel it very monotonous, and I do not want to force myself to and sector that I'm not fully passionate or high enough conviction of. So that's exactly where I thought that, okay, it's time that I could move out. I'm still heading the board, I still advise the company and strategy. There is no way that you could allow your baby to be have new guardians. So I still make sure that I visit once in a week to see what's happening. I'm still on low transition time. But the only difference is my security makes me sign my own registers that we kept. But everything else is almost the same. And of course, we have a wonderful CEO who's come from IBM, who's at the helm of the operations. And we've already seen success after being at the helm of the operations. So, and for me, as I told you, it was all about the purpose. Yeah, we have one question there.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Bhavna, and my question to you is, at such a young age, how do you decide you really want to be an entrepreneur, and what were the things that made you feel that, at such a young age, 14 only, had so many challenges to face, still you were ready to go against everything, and what you had in your mind?
Sure, I mean, I'll make it short. So the one of the biggest thing is, as I told, I hailed from middle class family. I didn't have a computer at home, and I had my school friends who had email addresses. So at least about 14 or 15 years back, having an email account was something that we could be proud of. And I had my friends showing off the fact that I had an email account on hotmail.com, it could be yahoo.com, and that's exactly where I felt that, is there any way I could request my brother, who had the access to visit internet shops, because he was in his engineering, and he had the additional subsidies from my dad not to use his pocket money in case if he's going to an internet cafe. So I tagged along with him to an internet cafe, signed up for a first email account, very excited, shared the password to all my friends that this is my email account and my password. And that's exactly when I was the laughing stock of my class, that's exactly where I felt that I can't be so stupid, I can't allow my friends to pull my leg always. Is there any way I could go to the internet shop again? And that's exactly where I started to work in the internet cafe when he went for lunch. And I was a freelancer building websites, and I was really enjoying into it. So I really enjoyed internet business. I loved building websites when I started off, because it was easy to learn. I had to learn simple HTML, I had to learn CGI or Perl programming then, and we were building websites. I was a freelancer who was lifted in a website called elance.com, where it's like a marketplace where this American company starts hiring them. Finally, there was one fine day, there was one of these American companies who told they do not want to work with me because I was too young, and they were afraid that if I didn't even have a mustache at my age, and they felt that how professional would your work be because you've not even completed the basic education and qualification. And that's exactly where I felt that I do not want to share my CVs to anyone else. Is there any way I could build my own company so that I'm on the other end where I'm going to receive CVs? And the most important is that, so being your own boss is still fun, because I had the freedom to do what I wanted to do. And it wasn't for sure easy. So sadly, the media has been focusing on the success stories, but there were multiple failures when you start very young, including prejudice, that you face within your board members, within the management. As I told, somebody in your board stands up and tells that, so you're for your ages, my experience, you need to listen to me. So it's been very interesting, but I was very passionate about the purpose. I saw that American companies wanted to sell stuff online. They wanted e-commerce platforms. Is there any way I could build a website for them? That's exactly how I started off with. The owner of the Cyber Cafe was my mentor. He started to advise me to do it. Yeah. It was the passion of the fire in the belly that ignited me to opt for this. Okay, so with this, thank you so much. It was absolutely fantastic to be here for the second time. And every time I visited, the institution, I could see the positive vibes and the positive energy. So it's all because of the philosophy of the institution and the values that they follow. So thank you so much. And I hope we could engage on building a startup ecosystem, at least for the women within this institute. Thank you so much. Thank you.